Hi, I'm a soft skills trainer from the Department of Career Planning and Development, and today we are going to be talking about a topic, fear of public speaking. Today we are going to be discussing about ways to overcome your fear of public speaking. I've got a lot of tips for you, so let's get started. The first one is get organized. When you've organized all your thoughts and materials, it helps you become calm and relaxed. And when you have a clear, organized thought, it greatly reduces your speaking anxiety because you can now better focus on the job at hand, and thus you're able to give a great speech. Second is practice and prepare extensively. Well, nothing takes place of practicing and preparing your speech. Write out a script with your key points, but don't read out the script word to word, because when you prepare your speech, well, you are able to answer all the questions asked by the audience. In case you have crammed your speech, that is not going to help you in any way, because if you, God forbid, out of nervousness forget your speech, then you'll not be able to carry forward. Eliminate fear of rejection. Well, don't think about the things like, what if my audience hates my speech, or what if they boo me off the stage. Try to not think all these negative thoughts and think positive. Think that the audience is there to listen to you for a reason, because you have more knowledge and you want to impart that knowledge to the audience. Focus on patterns. When you speak, try to get into a rhythm or a flow of some sorts. Keep your sentences short and to the point, and repeat the key points, the points that you know are going to be impactful in your speech. A short pause in between points can add anticipation to what you're going to say next, and it builds the interest of the audience. Watch yourself in the mirror. Well, that's the oldest trick in the book to learn public speaking. When you look at your own expressions, when you look at your own self in the mirror, you are highly judgmental, and all your inhibitions about what people might think of you fade away. So practice your speech in front of a mirror as if you were speaking directly to someone. So if you really want to learn and improve your public speaking, there are certain things that you need to bring your attention to. That is your facial expressions and your gestures, your body movements, and basically how welcome you appear. So when you have a gentle expression and a calm demeanor, when you speak, the audience are going to be more attracted towards you and what you have to say. Record yourself and learn your voice. Well, this is a technique which is now very much applicable because of the technology at hand. So record your speech on your phone or videograph yourself on a camera. Record yourself giving the talk from beginning to the end, and then listen to it or watch it and make notes of how you could make it better. So that way it is going to give you a very in-depth analysis of yourself and how do you sound or how do you appear on stage. Work on your breathing. When you focus on your breathing, your voice will have more resonance and you will relax way better. So breathe calmly and focus on getting into a rhythm. Although this is a public speaking exercise, breath work will help reduce stress, and it also helps in improving clarity in all areas of life. Practice, practice, practice. So the key word is practice. The more you practice, the less nervous you will be. Give your speech to another person. So there are plenty of people you can actually practice on. Be sure to tell the person to be completely honest with you, and if they are a good critique of you, that is all the more better. People you can practice on are your significant other, that is your spouse, your friends, your parents, or even your pet or your dog. Believe me, they are the best people who will actually give you a good feedback, except for your dog, of course. So getting a feedback from them would actually let you know what all areas are there that you really need to focus on, and if they have any questions for you, then that means that the same questions would be arising in the minds of the audience. So that's a good way to start working on your public speaking skills. Take public speaking classes. Now, if nothing else, take professional help, if that is what it takes. Public speaking classes basically help you in a very professional manner, giving you techniques about your breathing, about your intonation, about your appearance, about your speaking skills. So you can actually use a coach in case nothing else works. Lightly exercise before speaking. So when I say lightly exercise, I don't say go to the gym and huff and puff. Lightly exercise as in take a walk or do some stretching. Basically anything that would actually help bringing oxygen to your brain, because that will actually make you feel more live and more energetic. So that is a trick that actually helps you and calms you down before you actually get in front of a public. Now, a PowerPoint can really be good or bad. Sometimes having a PowerPoint can be your best friend, really. It can help you if you lose train of your thought. So keep your audiences engaged and give people a good place to grab notes on or the main points from. But if there are paragraphs written on your PowerPoint presentation, then that becomes very complicated and you yourself at times get nervous, because if you're following the paragraphs and the minute writing in your PPT, then that actually impacts your presentation in a very negative way. Certain public figures like Warren Buffett had a public speaking anxiety too. Now, if Buffett got over his fears by teaching investing principles to people twice his age, even you can do that. He forced himself to talk to people, and this is something that even I did in my career. I had stage fright way back before I actually got into this profession. So in order to overcome that, I actually started taking up things or opportunities where I was able to speak in front of audience, and that is how I was able to let go of the fear of public speaking. Sip water that's warm or at room temperature. Don't ever have cold water or sugary beverages, because they would actually help, they would actually dry out your throat, or the cold water might seize your throat. So don't go for things like cold beverages and sugary drinks. Go for always warm water or water at room temperature that actually helps you lubricate your throat. Pick out a subject that you really care about. Now, how to pick a subject that you really care about? The subject should have an ordinate impact on you. You want to share it with others, and you're really intensely aware of all the nitty-gritties of the subject, and you have complete knowledge, because when you speak from your heart, you are able to speak really well. So make sure that when you are practicing public speaking, always pick up a subject that you care about, not something that you don't know about and you have to research. Always know 100 words for every word that you speak. Now, not literally 100 words, but basically you need to know alternative words that are suitable for that particular word that you're going to be speaking. So in case your audience are not able to understand what you're saying, then always make sure that you have an alternate ready in your mind about a certain verbiage or certain words that are heavy duty. Focus on material, not the audience. So focus on delivering your material in the best possible way. Don't worry about what the audience reactions are going to be. Relax and forget about your fear of public speaking. Now, it's easier said than done, but try to not stress about it and try not thinking about what the people might be thinking of you or the judgments that people might pass on you. So always relax and just concentrate on the subject that you want to talk about, not the actual public speaking fear. Don't overthink your audience's reactions. There's always somebody in the crowd who's either going to be looking at his or her phone, or is going to be talking to someone, or they are going to be yawning. So when somebody does that, you don't feel disheartened that the people are losing interest in what you're saying. Just don't focus on the audience reactions and don't take it personally. They are not judging you. They're just there, and their attention is as long as it can be there. So make sure that they, and you understand that they are here to listen to you, and don't pay any attention to all these small details. Avoid talking too fast. So out of nervousness, if you end up talking too fast, that actually makes you breathe really hard, and that will have an impact on your speech delivery. So the audience will not be able to comprehend what you're saying. So make sure that you practice speaking slowly in front of the public. Make your nervous energy work for you. So learn to channel your nervous energy into a positive energy, and being nervous is a form of adrenaline really. So you can use it in a positive way to help give an impassioned presentation during a public speaking event really. Pay any price and spend any amount of money to speak well. Now, if you're really interested and really serious about learning public speaking, then make a decision right now that you want to learn and speak to learn as well. So be very willing to pay the price and go to lengths to achieve your goal. Don't let it just slide. Because the more you practice, the more you put in your energies, the more you will learn. Meditate for 5 minutes a day. Well, when I say meditate for 5 minutes a day, it actually helps calm your nerves and soothe you, because you know, it kind of brings your thoughts into perspective, and that helps you feel less nervous. Find a friend to focus on. Now that's a bonus trick really. In case you are really nervous during public speaking, find one person that you really focus your attention on, and you give the speech to that person. This is in the worst case scenarios really. So that actually helps you deliver the speech in front of the audience. I hope these tips were able to help you. Thanks for watching. Bye now.